I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
If you're heading to the Blue Palace, you might want to rethink that outfit.
Sorry, I was lost in thought. I'm planning my wedding, you see. So many details to work out.
Wait! Hear my plea!
Oh, thank you. My master has... Now he refuses to even see me, lest I saw... No! Oh, and you'll need the hip bone. Oh, you just don't understand. Without him, I am not free. Without him, I am doomed. All
Some
of this
say
empire
I got my position
shall fall
because
into
my
chaos.
Is the Emperor. Nonsense.
All right.
The man's given me nothing. He can't even be bothered to attend my wedding.
Say, Ulfric Stormcloak murdered the High King with his voice.
So excited. Oh, I'd get in trouble for that. It's not allowed. Well, I suppose in that case it's okay to let you in. But only briefly. Be careful and come right back.
Please, don't interrupt the court.
I swear to you, unnatural magics are coming from that cave. There are strange noises and lights. We need someone to investigate.
Then we will immediately send out a legion to scour the cave and secure the town. Hafengar's people will always be safe under
Your
my
Eminence,
rule.
Your Eminence, my scrying has suggested nothing in the area. Dragonbridge is under Imperial control. This is likely superstitious nonsense.
Perhaps a more tempered reaction? Might be called for?
Oh, yes, of course, you were right. Falk, tell Captain Aldous I said to assign a few extra soldiers to Dragonbridge.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. But about the cave?
I will have someone take care of the cave as well, Varnius. You can rest easy. You're dismissed.
Do you have business with the court? You mean the Dragon Bridge issue? I'll be honest with you. They're half... I don't think it's worth our time with the war going on. But if you want to clear out the cave... That was over 500 years ago. Nothing much down there now. But everyone's always convinced the cave is haunted.
If I needed something from you. Nothing. I'm busy, and I don't like being bothered unless I'm expecting something from you. Oh, don't give me that look. We have something of a vampire problem. I don't expect you to be capable of even that. I can teach you, but I won't be held responsible for what you do with the knowledge. Take a look. Vampires are clever hunters. More clever than you, definitely.
Pally, my dear.
Oh, I couldn't. It goes right through me. Besides, I have so many things to do. So many undesirables to contend with. Naysayers, buffoons, detractors. Why, my headsman hasn't slept in 3 days.
You are far too hard on yourself, my dear, sweet, homicidally insane Pelagius. What would the people do without you? Dance? Sing? Smile? Grow old? You
yes?
are the best septim that's ever ruled. Well, except for that Martin fella. But he turned into a dragon god, and that's hardly sporting. You know, I was there for that whole sordid affair. Marvelous time! Butterflies, blood, a fox, a severed head, ho-ho-ho, and the cheese! To die for.
Yes, yes, as you've said countless times before.
Harumph! Well, then, if you're going to be like that, perhaps it's best I take my leave. A good day to you, sir. I said good day!
Yes, yes, go. Leave me to my ceaseless responsibilities and burdens.
How rude! Can't be bothered to host an old friend for a decade or two. Inside the mind of Oh, is it your first time? Pelagius the... Now, surely even you know about Pelagius's decree. Real? Ooh! Well, spit it out! Actually, but seriously, what's the message? Wait! Was it more? I'm wrong. Ha! No, Matt. But Mort. Because that's... crazy! You do realize Who you're... Jolly good guess. But only half right. I'm a mad god. The mad god. Now you... But only... If not, then call... Now that's the... So... On one... You have to find the way out first. Well, good luck with that. Ha! I do love it. Care to take a look around? Welcome. Now, I... The Wubberjack! Huh? Huh? Didn't see that coming, did you? Do you mind? I'm busy doing the fish stick. It's a very delicate state of... Oh, good choice! Well, good for me. I find everyone being out to get you so terribly entertaining. Yeah. You might find it less so. You see, Pelagius' mother was, well, let us say, unique. Although I suppose, in the grand scheme of things, she was fairly average. That woman wielded fear like a cleaver. Or did she wield a cleaver and make people afraid? I never get that part right. Oh, but she taught her son well. Pelagius learned at a very early age that danger could come from anywhere, at any time, delivered by anyone. The objective here is simple, you simpleton. Use your Wubberjack, then defeat the enemy, or they do the same. Oh, I thought you'd never figure it out. With the threat gone, Pelagius is under the delusion that he's safe, which means you've helped him out, sort of. And we're that much closer to home. Now this is a sad path. Pelagius hated and feared many things. Assassins, wild dogs, the undead, pumpernickel. But the deepest, keenest hatred was for himself. Here. The attacks he makes on himself can be seen here fully. They're always carried out on the weakest part of his fragile self. The self-loathing enhances Pelagius' anger. His confidence will strengthen with every hit. You must bring the two into balance. Wonderfully done. Hades is finally ready to love himself and continue hating everyone else. Busy doing the fish mortal? Insufferable. Yes, yes, you're entirely brilliant. Conquering madness and all that, blah, 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 blah. But you're not done yet! And you could still die. You've headed down the path of dreams. Unfortunately for you, Pelagius suffered night terrors from a young age. All you need to do is find something to wake our poor Pelagius up. You'll find his terrors easy to repel, but persistent. that's something to crow about. With Pelagius up and about, you're moving right along. We'll both be home in no time. Do you mind? I'm busy doing the fish. Fixed is such a subjective term. I think treated is far more appropriate, don't you? Like one does to a rash or an arrow in the face. Ah, but no matter. Heartless mortal that you... So, congrats! I've been known to change my mind. So, Pelagius Septim III, once the mad emperor of Tamriel, now so boringly sane. I always knew he had it in him. Well, I suppose it's back to the Shivering Isles. The trouble Haskell can get into while I'm gone simply boggles the mind. Let's make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Clothes? Check. Beard? Check. Luggage? Luggage? Now where did I leave my luggage?
Master, you've taken me back. Does this mean we're going home? Oh, happy times. I can't wait to...
Yes, yes, that's quite enough celebration. Let's send you ahead, shall we? As for you, my little mortal minion, feel free to keep the Wabba Jack as a symbol of my... I'll just take the damn thing. You take care of yourself now. And if you ever find yourself up in New Sheo, do look me up. We can share a strawberry tart! Ha ha! Ta-ta!
Soon, I can almost taste it.
be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of need.
Someone do something.
Help. Hello, I'm Gisli. But you can just call me. It would seem so. Nah, I don't think so. Welcome to the center of the world. Or at least my brother Eriker's world. We'll speak again later, if we must.
Watch the skies, traveler.
Welcome to the center of the world. Or at least,
it would seem so. Not my problem.
Too old to work. That don't make me too old to drink.
What is it? Dragons?
Tools, wares, and weapons. All for sale at fair price.
Fortune smiles upon...
All right. But if you get arrested, do not blame it on me.
The warm sand and elsewhere is far from here.
The winking skeevers got warm beds and cold mead. You look like you could use both.
Picked a bad time to get lost, friend.
I think you'll bleed.
That's the best you can do.
Yeah. Still can.
fools! Roga! Yeah!